I'll send it in. All right, say less.
Hell,
say less. All right.
So now going into game one, we have Daijibu Lid and Daijibu Matty G versus Ling and Light for Winter Semis. Ling and Rogue Light, excuse me.
Yeah, of course. You got to put some respect on my boy's name.
Excuse me.
Put some respect on my boy's name. Now, this is what I call one of the juiciest matches we're going to see today. We're going to have the blitzing electric man himself, Paris Light Ramirez, going in with Ling Ling here to do some destruction. But, of course, Kool-Aid and Matty G, these guys are legends in New England for their amazing doubles play.
Yeah, and now they're going their mains here. Before, they're going Pichu Wolf, and now we're seeing the Krom Cena. This is just, I think this is just a super good doubles team on its own. Because Krom is going to be super aggro, and then Ling, Lucina can just cover it with super good offstage oppression and just super solid neutral on its own.
Oh my goodness.
With the up smash there, going to get up smashed by Life First Shovels. And the first stock going to green team with the lead.
Yeah, that's going to be Matty G kind of looking that one a little bit early there. But, of course, he is, as you said, team. Oh, God, good, beautiful counter coming out. That's kind of free against the Space Animals. You just go down there, you force them to use their up special recovery, and then you just go down and counter. And, you know, that's why this team should do pretty well against Light. If I'm this team, I'm looking to bully Light, get him offstage, and just edgeguard him relentlessly, because the moment he's forced to use that Firefox to recover, it's curtains. Family does matter, and that's why we do have Krom Lucina.
I think both of these sword characters do actually pretty well versus Fox, because both of them have the counter to oppress him offstage. Maddie's just going to go too far, get edgeguarded too far offstage for him to be able to recover.
That's the other thing, right? The base knockback on turnips is kind of absurdly high.
Yeah, it's
so
super
if
good.
Maddie gets caught by a turn from Ling Ling, that's going to be his stock as well. Yep. And here we go. Oh, no help. Oh, easy.
Oh, yeah.
And he's still getting this pressure going. Maddie, you know, finally managing to connect a blow there, but only after so much damage is racked up.
Yeah, and now they finally got Link's first stock off, but right now, Yellow Team down to their last three stocks. Maddie's on his last stock, and he's getting pressured right now. He's able to fair him off, get him out of his face, but.
Oh, spot dodge.
Down throw, hit him with the back air. Nope. Hits him with the up air just to take it off of me.
Oh, my goodness. That was. The ball's on him, just kind of go for that Fox Illusion right in the face of Kool-Aid, trying to go for a little mix-up. But Kool-Aid, oh, okay, we'll go for that stage strike. Let's go, Matty G.
Yeah, let's go, Matty. Bringing it back to even, pretty, almost even. Green team's at a fairly low percent, and Yellow's at a high percent right now.
Yeah, Matty G needs to try and stay alive, but staying alive will not happen. Gonna go ahead and steal that stock, Gloria Gaynor style. Now, it's all good.
Yeah. This is definitely a hard position for Yellow team right now. Light and Ling just seem so comfortable right now. Yeah, and up smash and lead for his shovel too.
Now what can Maddie do here? He's putting up.
Light's gonna have to put in some hard work here, and not go off stage for even a second.
Oh my god!
Double jab. F-tilt.
Oh my god! Oh my god! Yo, my man is clean.
He's saucing him right now.
Why didn't you let him get the clip, Maddie? You should have let him get the clip.
Yeah, come on.
That's a wrap.
Yeah, that's just gonna be game one.
That was crisp, though. I'm gonna say
that was super good for me.
Because the thing was, you know, what got me is here. You're gonna see it, right? He's gonna go for the up tilt, and right here, if this was Smash 4, he would have hip checked his ass.
Yep. And then him again. He wanted the other no attack, but hit him with the skid cancel F smash.
The resets,
and then he wanted the shine. Yeah, that was just so smart by Lay. Lay with his super good knowledge on Fox, known just, on every single punish, every single
punch. That's kind of what I expect the Smash Ultimate to devolve to at some point, where you're just kind of resetting people into hard knockdown scenarios, and then either reacting or guessing correctly and just doing it, racking up damage, forcing them off stage, and then going for the edge guard, confirming a KO off a jab reset. Yep. Light did such an immaculate job there of just showing how comfortable he felt. Man, I really wish hip checks were in this game.
Yeah, hip checks definitely were a thing in Smash
they were
sick. I don't know how much I was a fan of hip checks in Smash 4.
I mean, getting hit by it sucked, but like,
definitely wasn't fun to be hit by, but for a commentator's perspective, that was hype. But see, game two, we might have a switch from either player on Yellow Team. I know they both have a variety of characters that you're going to, but Lade right now going for the headphones instead.
And we're already noticing, right? At this point, Lade's like, all right, we're deep enough in bracket where that Pichu you saw me using earlier, I'm not really feeling that Pichu anymore, right? You saw him immediately go with Lucina game one. It looks like Maddie go ahead and select the Krom. Now, Maddie does have Wolf as well, so they were probably discussing that. Yo, bro, do you think I should go Wolf, or do you think? I was like, just stay Krom. So,
I think Wolf could be a good play as well, I will say.
Yeah, I don't think either of those choices are a bad one.
Yeah. Game two going into Town and City, though. Opting for a bigger stage from Pokemon Stadium, and goes for the raw grab. No pummel, no anything.
That was kind of weird, man. That was like a Ghost Rider level 3, I call that. you know, in Ultimate Marvel's Capcom 3, where you have to look into his eyes.
Yeah.
And he just stares at you.
Yeah, he stares lovingly. Yep. He has lead off Siege here. It's just that's definitely a scenario that's pretty hard for Peach. Is edge guarding Lucina, a character with a really, really good disjoint up B, has moves just stop you from edge guarding.
Oh.
Ooh.
Oh, how did that happen?
That just didn't work out for him. Yeah, Firefox just has. Firefox has just a significantly bigger hitbox than it did in Smash 4 for the surrounding, so he definitely just wanted to try to fair him, but ended up trading and Light not going as far as Lucina did there.
Yeah, Light just went in the completely other direction, too. Oh yeah. My goodness, that turned up comfort.
Gets Maddie out of there, too.
Ling Ling. Yeah. That's the thing. I'm saying I've yet to see someone use turnips to the effectiveness that Ling Ling has. Yep. My man is terrifying.
Yep. Ling Ling is definitely... he's definitely holding it down for this match right now. He's definitely the MVP for Green Team.
The somersault off the top.
That's not it. Another up air. Oh wow, that was just super good awareness from both players. Hit him with the up smash to up E.
He just parried a float cancel nair from Ling, but that move is so fast it didn't even matter. Oh my god.
Ooh,
okay, that works out.
Oh, what did he hit him with? What just happened?
We're taking it, big dog.
Yeah, we really are gonna take those. And now it's back to even. Yellow team with a slight lead here because Light's on his last stock.
Okay, and a forward tilt coming out. Light are trying to get down here. They just need to get Light off stage, and that can be a very easy edge guard scenario. And look, beautiful retaliation from Light, noticing that Ling was starting to get comboed, and there was probably another forward air coming from Kool-Aid after that, so he just goes ahead and interrupts it. But man, it is a slaughter fest down here.
Yeah, this is rough.
Right?
Yeah, Yellow Team definitely has the adaptation right now. They were looking a little rough at the beginning of the game, let alone game one. But I think they have a pretty good adaptation right now. Oh, nice air dodge instead of upping because he knew he would have got hit there.
Yeah, to that point, Maddie losing that stock. We just have one more. Ling now the healthiest man on the screen.
Yeah, and Light right now, I said about 2 minutes ago that Light was the farthest down, but he's only taken about 70% right now and was able to take two stocks to bring it back to like even and have a lead for
Green
Team.
God, you see how that jab?
Smash not gonna take it.
I'm surprised, even.
Yeah, and Ling has dot eyes here, which is probably the second best turn you have. There's a decent amount, but yep, gonna be the stock.
Looking at it now, he's holding shield, Light, trying to stay alive as best as possible, trying to get that sharking up air, but Maddie G is here with the pressure, tries to go for the jab, rawr back air, will not find it, but that forward tilt will be enough. It's all up to one man with one dream, the barber himself, Ling Ling.
And I think Ling Ling can actually do pretty well for this comeback, but we might see some team combos here from Lady Maddie, from Team Daijabu.
No, he just did a falling up air and a spot dodge.
Yeah, just afraid of a move to come out. Fair, up air.
Okay,
double up air.
Ladders?
Runs in the family, up air to up air.
Well, he's just trying to end this as quickly as possible. 70% racked up on Ling Ling already. No lay, trying to run away because he is the more damaged one. And the moment this goes down to 1v1s can be a lot more difficult. This is very doable for Ling Ling.
And I know... And only a little bit more percent, there's going to be some jab combos that's going to be able to confirm a kill for Maddie. Jab back air, jab fair, jab up air.
Deuces!
And yep, he had to grab pummel for that F smash. And do you know if, I wonder if top 8 is best of 5 or if it's just winners, losers, grand finals?
It's probably top 4.
Top 4? Yeah, you don't know. We'll see.
Top 4 or top 3.
We're having going into a game 3 situation here, though, regardless.
They're talking it out.
Yep. Lee knows. Lee was just like, yep, we gotta keep doing that.
He's like, yeah, that was good. That was good. And Maddie's like, yeah, bro. I messed him up.
Yeah,
he's like, yeah. Use them jail strats.
Jail strats. I learned this one combo in jail where if one dude grabs the other dude, one guy grabs the guard, bro, and I just.
Oh, I don't know about that. Oh, I don't know about that.
We're gonna be going back to a Pokemon stage here.
Dun, 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 dun.
Pokemon got such good music.
I mean, yeah, definitely, you know, for how many stages? We got Pokemon Stadium 1, sometimes we use 2, and then we got Unova. Definitely the bangers of Ultimate are on those stages. We do got some Persona music now, though. But.
Yeah, Persona has some pretty good music. Game 3, going back to Pokemon Stadium 2 here, and we might be able to see some adaptation from Game 1.
There we go. All right. Guaranteed conversions from Kool-Aid here. Yep. Trying to shark as best he can. And look at that. It's like they seamlessly hand off of whom they're pressuring, right? We saw that Matty G was attacking Light there and immediately just pass it off to Kool-Aid.
Yeah. Yeah, right now, it was a 1v1, but now they're just coming in to save the other. It's just going to be so many Phlox. Phlox just does so much percent on so many good combo moves. Oh, he parried the pummel. That's super funny. Yeah. Right now, Maddie's just doing a super good job of stuffing any aerial approach from either player on green team right now.
Yeah, Maddie's looking a lot more comfortable. Beautiful parry. Tries to go for the down smash, but not quite fast enough of a move. Oh my god, the fear!
Oh, Jesus.
But Light is just so smart. He just sits in shield and says, do something, bro. You won't.
Nothing yet.
Okay. They're on opposite sides, they're separated. This is exactly what the green team needs.
Yep.
All right, there goes Maddie.
Yeah. He was very, yeah, that's the one thing that Peach actually does have for green team here is Peach counter can just absolutely demolish Crom's up B, and he tried to space away from it to not get hit by it, but he ended up knocking the ledge out of it.
Okay, clean from Ling with the timing mix up with the back air to go ahead and close up that stock. It looks like everybody's falling left and right except for Ling Ling, now the one with three stocks on the board still, looking to get a down tilt probably because everyone's at low percent here, so he can really carry that into a lot of damage to be able to find that opening. But first, he's to make it back down to the ground. Looks like he will. He's looking to find that opening still.
He caught the horizontal illusion to ledge with an F smash, which is able to kill him. That was kind of some sus DI there too as well. Almost had him off stage with that.
Okay. Maddie being forced off stage once again. Yep. Has to get past Light somehow. He doesn't have Kool-Aid to help him, but it looks like he's just going to jump right over Light Shield, and Light's going to let him get back center stage pretty much free here.
Yeah, this is a scary spot here.
But they still haven't been able to reconvene. You saw that entire time, and there goes Kool-Aid as well. These two have been split up for a large majority of this match, and Light and Ling Ling are just doing such a good job of keeping them on opposite sides of the stage and separated that they haven't really had a chance to get much momentum going. Now, this could be the start of something, but as I say that, you know, there we go. Trying to get the sandwich going. Right now, messes up a little bit. This is not what you want.
Yeah, this is, it's just definitely going to be a lot of, Light's going to have to put in a lot of work right now to just not lose on this last stock, because as soon as he does, it'll just be even, and he doesn't really want to take Ling's stock here. So he's getting comboed a little bit. Oh yeah, that's just Smash 4 illusion on shield. He's just expecting to go through, but it just stops him altogether.
Yeah, it's coming down to the final moments. Beautiful falling upper from Maddie, and now you know, team father and son, rather daughter, I guess.
Oh, the just fade back F smash to hit the side B, and now this is definitely not out of the realm of possibility for yellow team here.
Yeah,
it's still definitely doable.
The thing is, they can rack up damage on to Light very easily. If either one of them lands a falling up air, that's going to leech at least 40-50%.
Oh, yeah. This is scary. I think right now, both of the green team is just doing a good job of separating yellow teams and not be able to save the other. And, yep, fair on the shield of the fair into the up smash.
Yeah, looks like that was a best of three.
Yep. Green team would have taken over yellow team. Game three. That was super close.
Yeah, no, I mean, definitely... you know, we were saying, like, Matty G and Kool-Aid are amazing at teams, and it showed. You know, they did a very good job. They had some lightning moments, but Ling Ling and Light just kind of proved to be a little bit much for them to get through.
Yeah.
We're definitely going to be seeing more of them in losers, though, as they climb their way up. Definitely will probably be in the top four-ish areas where we kind of expect them to land.